Hello my lovelies and welcome back to my channel. My name is Dr. Ozcan and today I wanted to go through a topic that is a very worrying for a lot of parents, including myself, the rising numbers of the invasive Group A streptococcus. There is so much misinformation out online, so I hope this video will give you a bit of information and make you better equipped at looking out for some of the signs that will prompt you to have a chat with your doctor. Okay, so a little bit of a background. What is Group A strep? So it's a type of bacteria, and the difference between bacteria and viruses is that a bacteria has what we call a cell wall, and it's essentially like a living cell, whereas a virus is sort of like a walking piece of DNA. And this means that it is treatable with antibiotics, which is a big difference to things like COVID, because there are no specific antivirals that will help. So Group A strep is actually a bacteria that a lot of us carry on our skin, and it causes us no harm. And when it does, the symptoms are usually quite mild. So we can get things like tonsillitis, we can get infections of the skin around the mouth called impetigo, we can get infection of skin around our body, specifically called cellulitis, and it can also lead to scarlet fever, which is what we keep hearing in the news recently. Besides these sort of mild-ish responses to the bacteria, we can also get infections such as pneumonia, which is infection of the lung tissue, meningitis, which is infection of the lining of the brain, and something called septic arthritis, which is infection of the joints. So let's talk about scarlet fever, because that is something that a lot of people haven't heard before. So the main symptoms of scarlet fever is usually a high temperature, sore throat with swollen glands, and often about 12 to 48 hours later, you get a typical rash, which is a raised pinprick sort of rash all over, normally, not just in one area. And when you have a feel of it, it's sort of like sandpaper texture. Now, we see lots of photos of this online, and it's usually on Caucasian skin, so it's very important to also recognize this on black and ethnic minority skin types. And the thing to know that you might not get the red appearance, but it should still be raised and have that sandpaper texture. And you get other things with this as well. You get the slap cheek appearance, with the area around the mouth is usually spared. In addition to this, when they stick out their tongue, you might notice that it sort of looks a little bit like a strawberry. The most important thing to know at this point is that if you spot any of these symptoms, not to worry, but contact your doctor, because it is treatable with antibiotics. Now to the worrying side of Group A streptococcus, and that is the invasive Group A streptococcus. And it is this that has led to 9 children having lost their lives since September. But it's still really important to know that relative to what Group A streptococcus can cause, it is still very uncommon, but it is wise to know the symptoms. So it is not really known why the invasive type of Group A streptococcus is on the rise. There is no new strain. It is just thought that there is an increased number of bacteria circulating in our communities, because now we're mingling a little bit more than we did 2 years ago in the pandemic. So the risk factors for children who get this are those that are immunocompromised, meaning that their immune system is not working to the optimum. They have open wounds in which the bacteria can get into. And if they've had a recent severe viral infection, that can make their lungs more susceptible to being infected with Group A streptococcus, which is thought to be one of the reasons why we're seeing them more now. Here's to the important part. We advise you to contact your GP or the 111 service if you have any of these with your child. If you feel like your child is generally getting worse and not getting better, if they're not feeding very well, if your child has a dry nappy for over 12 hours or hasn't passed urine and you feel like they are becoming dehydrated, if your baby is under 3 months and has a temperature of over 38, or if they're older than 3 months and they have a temperature higher than 39, you must call 999 or attend A&E if any of these apply. Your child is finding it difficult to breathe. They're making grunting noises as they're breathing, and you may notice that their chest wall is being sucked in when they're trying to breathe in and out. This is what we call respiratory distress, and it shows us that the child is working really, really hard to breathe. There are pauses when your child is breathing. Your child's skin or tongue is blue. Your child is floppy, is finding it difficult to stay awake, or is extremely drowsy. I know that this is a very worrying time for everyone, and prevention is usually better than cure. So one of the things that we have learned through the pandemic is hand hygiene, and also if you go to cough and sneeze into a tissue, as bacteria spreads through respiratory droplets and also from direct skin contact. I hope that eases some of your anxiety. The most important thing to do is focus on prevention, make sure you're aware of the signs and symptoms, and try to keep well. Thank you for watching, guys. Bye.